In this video clip, we show you the management of a slipped prosthesis. This is the right ear. The patient is under local anesthesia, as in all our cases. The canal wall incisions are being given a few millimeters lateral to the annulus with the help of a stapes or a Rosen's knife. Using a cotton ball to help us, the canal wall skin is being elevated and the middle ear is being entered. We use a probe or a curved pick for this purpose, and once the middle ear is entered, the incus can be seen very clearly. The piston can be seen lying on the promontory. So this patient had a recurrent conductive hearing loss. The posterior superior bony overhang is being curetted out to give us a better view of the incus and also of the footplate. The bone removal is usually carried out to the junction of the body and the long process of the incus. Using a fine right angle probe, the piston which was lying inside the middle ear is gently removed, and once this is removed, the footplate area comes into clear view. Using a 0.2 millimeter right angled pick, the old fenestra in the footplate, which was not sufficient, is enlarged, and in this case we remove the posterior half of the footplate, giving us a reasonably wide fenestra. Bone is being removed to remove any remnants of footplate which may cause SN loss if dislodged into the vestibule. These bony spicules are removed. We have a fenestra of adequate size. Once the fenestra has been made, the length of the piston required is measured using a measuring rod. Once the required length has been calculated, a Teflon piston of adequate size and length, in this case approximately 0.6 millimeters in diameter into 4.5 millimeters length, is inserted and manipulated into position. In this kind of revision stapedectomy, the results are excellent and the patient gets back his normal hearing by means of complete closure of the airborne gap. The piston is now in its final position. It is stabilized and the fenestra closed by a piece of dry gel foam. Some more gel foam is used to complete the closure of the fenestra, and the piston can then be crimped in place. We use a fine alligator forceps or a special crimping forceps for this purpose. The Teflon piston is tightly crimped and you can see its final position. The movement of the articular chain is being checked now, and you can see movement of the malleus brings about a corresponding movement of the incus and the Teflon piston. That is the end of the operation. The flap is being replaced and the patient has a routine post-operative recovery. Thank you.